pay attention to this. Right now, a nationwide measles outbreak is getting worse.
Disease is going to spread very quickly.
This anti-vax movement has proven to be very dangerous, dangerous, dangerous.
In recent years, there has been a significant resurgence of the virus measles, also known as rubeola. Healthline defines measles as a viral infection that starts in the respiratory system. Despite the fact that it's almost always easily preventable with the use of a measles vaccine, this virus continues to remain a significant cause of death around the world. According to the World Health Organization, the measles virus was responsible for 110,000 deaths worldwide in the year 2017, with the majority of these deaths being children under the age of 5 years old. What's more, it is currently on the rise in the United States as well. With measles exacting such a heavy toll, it's never been more important to make sure you know everything there is to know about this disease, in order to best ensure that both you and your loved ones are as protected as possible. Before we start, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the notification bell in order to stay up to date on our daily videos and content. Common causes. Measles is caused when a person becomes infected by a virus belonging to the paramyxovirus family. Like all other viruses, this infection consists of tiny microbes which take on a parasitic relationship with the host they infect. Once they have entered a host body, the viral microbes invade the host's cells and use the compounds from those cells to complete their life cycle. Typically, the first part of the body targeted by measles is the respiratory tract, consisting of the internal organs that are vital to our ability to breathe. From there, the disease can also potentially spread to other parts of the body as well, by hitching a ride through the bloodstream. There are 24 different genetic variations of the measles virus, although at this time of writing, only 6 of these measles variants are currently in circulation. Signs and symptoms. The telltale signs and symptoms of the measles virus usually do not manifest until sometime between 10 and 14 days after the initial infection. During this period, the virus incubates inside the host, with no visual or otherwise noticeable signifiers. After this initial incubation period, individuals affected by measles may begin to experience nonspecific symptoms that are typically milder in nature, such as a fever, cough, sore throat, runny nose, and swollen or inflamed eyes. This period of milder symptoms typically lasts somewhere around 2 or 3 days. After this period, those infected with the measles virus may experience a rash consisting of red spots and bumps that give the skin a blotchy appearance, usually first appearing on the face and spreading from there. During this period, the infected individual may also experience a significant spike in temperature, with fevers often rising as high as 105.8 degrees Fahrenheit or 41 degrees Celsius. Other common symptoms of measles is the appearance of small, whitish spots which form inside the mouth or inner cheeks, which are sometimes referred to as Koplik spots. Contagiousness and spreading. It's worth mentioning that the measles virus is also highly contagious, with infected patients running the risk of spreading the illness to others as well. The communicable period for measles is usually around 8 days in length. This period typically begins about 4 days before the first appearance of the skin rash and ends 4 days after the rash's first appearance. Measles is an airborne virus, meaning that it can be spread through particles in the air. If a person infected with measles coughs or sneezes, this releases respiratory droplets into the air, through which the virus can spread and latch onto objects and surfaces. As you might expect, touching a surface that these particles have settled on would, in turn, put you at risk for contracting the virus as well. According to the World Health Organization, the measles virus can survive and maintain infectious in the air or on surfaces for up to 2 hours, meaning that the risk factor of becoming infected persists for much longer than you might have expected. If you think your immune system can fight off the infection of measles on its own, think again. According to the Mayo Clinic, a susceptible person who comes in contact with the measles virus has a 90% chance of becoming infected themselves. If left unchecked, a person infected with measles can go on to spread the virus to anywhere between 9 and 18 other susceptible individuals as well. Diagnosis and prevention. When it comes to preventing the spread of the measles virus, the best way to protect yourself and your loved ones is to properly immunize yourself with the measles vaccine. On the World Health Organization's website, information on the vaccine and its availability is written thusly. Routine measles vaccination for children combined with mass immunization campaigns in countries with high case and death rates are key public health strategies to reduce global measles deaths. The measles vaccine has been in use for over 50 years. It is safe, effective, and inexpensive. It costs approximately $1 to immunize a child against measles. In the year 2017, approximately 85% of the world's children received at least one dose of the measles vaccine before their first birthday. However, it is also worth mentioning that about 15% of children do not receive full immunity from their first dosage of the vaccine. For that reason, it is recommended that every child receives at least two doses of the vaccine in order to ensure full protection and maximize the chance of developing an immunity to the virus. Unfortunately, the number of children worldwide who received two doses of the vaccine is comparatively less, covering only about 67% of all children in the year 2017. If you suspect that you or someone close to you either has measles or has been exposed to someone with measles, it is strongly recommended that you contact your doctor immediately. From there, medical professionals will be able to perform an evaluation and diagnosis to determine whether or not you have truly come in contact with the virus. This evaluation may include the examination of your skin for rashes, inspecting your mouth for white spots, and performing a blood test to try and locate the virus, as well as checking for some of the other more minor symptoms. Unfortunately, there is currently no effective treatment method for individuals who have already become infected by the measles virus. This is because, unlike with bacterial infections, viral infections, such as measles, are not sensitive to antibiotics. However, the virus and its symptoms typically disappear from the patient within 2 or 3 weeks. An infected person may be able to recover faster if they receive the measles vaccine within 72 hours of exposure to the virus, or if they receive a dose of immune proteins, known as immunoglobulin, within 6 days of the initial exposure. Like any disease, however, early prevention is always the safest, easiest, and most effective way to make sure you're covered. Did you find this video helpful? Do you have any other questions or concerns related to measles that you'd like to bring to the table? If so, we strongly encourage you to leave a comment in the section below and help us keep the conversation going. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie are we if we don't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.